Greetings, gamers and Kickstarter backers. Here we are to show you a new painting video of how to paint your Dwarven Forge cavern pieces. We've got our full array of our new color sets, a beautiful palette of colors. We've expanded our line, usable for painting miniatures as well. We've got our Picorni paints, our Picorni brushes, and a bunch of other stuff that we need here. Lizard men, fire newts, cans of water, paper towels, and Mr. C to urge us on. Let's get into it. And now, we're gonna show you how to turn the regular unpainted shore piece into a painted piece. We actually did one a little bit different. So I was showing you how you can get wild and wacky. Let's see how to paint the water cavern piece. Here we have your unpainted piece. You're ready to paint. Here I've got the deep water green. Right there, there's in my palette. I recommend getting some nice ceramic palettes. You see, mine are a little dirty. thing of water, you know, just in case, keep your brush clean. So, the first thing you're going to do for your water pieces is mix some of this deep water green, paint that into your water. Now, you don't want to get it into the shore, and you don't want to get it into the like coral-like areas. Just paint it up against the wall, water like that. I would do, as you don't have to, but I would go on the sides as well. You know, like that. So, there it is. Step one, very simple. Now you gotta wait for that to dry. Now, if you're like, I'm painting one piece, but if you have to paint like 50 of them, you know, by the time you're finished with your 50th one, the first piece will probably be dry. So, production line, that's the way I recommend you do it. One stage at a time. It's got to dry out. Okay, now that the deep water green is dry, we're going to go to the next stage, which is the cavern dry brushing stage. I'm gonna go with my bigger brush. I've got the cavern dry brush. Now what we're gonna do is we're gonna dry it out. Okay, and dry it out like as though we're gonna paint like a regular cavern piece. Okay, and we're gonna do that on the edge of the shore here. Look at that. There you go. That's all you need. There. Axe. Okay. That's it. Don't overdo it. After your cavern dry brush, we're gonna go to a mixture of cardboard and school bus. Cardboard and school bus. We're gonna mix these two together. Okay. See that? Mix these two together. You know, it doesn't have to be perfect. Just kind of mix them together.
50-50?
50-50. Like 50-50, more or less, you know, just get a kind of a nice, a little bit, not as bright as the school bus and not as dark as the cardboard. Mix it together. There you go. Now you're a real painter.
You're a real painter now, okay? And we're gonna dry that out on the paper towel, and we're gonna put that onto your piece, okay? All right, there you go. That's it. You're done. Okay. Tricky face here. Shallow water. Seaweed green. There we go. See, it's good to have all these little palettes, handy little palettes here. Okay, look at that. Now, I find that this part's, you're gonna have to be a little bit tricky with this part. What we do here, once again, with our medium brush, our number three brush, painting brush, we're gonna dry out this color, right? Dry brush, drying it out, and then we're gonna just sort of dry brush it near the shore here, okay? Determine, you know, a little finesse, how much you're gonna do it. You see what I'm doing here? Just hitting the shore with a little of this, kind of scrubbing it here. See that? So I've now scrubbed it, sort of, you know, just kind of a little bit of graduation there, you know, gradation. All right. All right, then we go to the moss green. There you go, moss green. Wow. And with this, you're going to paint in your moss in the moss green color. And I'm going to throw down a little here on this side of my little palette there. I'm going to cheat a little, and I'm going to make sure my brush is clean. I'm going to use my large brush, okay, and I'm going to dip it in the moss green, and drying it out. Make sure I'm going to get a new paper towel because this one's getting kind of grungy. Okay, and now you see where the water is hitting the shore. I'm going to throw down some moss there. There we go. And that's it. Throw down some moss. You know, now let's say I was doing this piece, you know, that has more shoreline, you know, then it would be more important to hit that moss, you know. But there you go. See, there, you know, a bunch of steps, but they're all very quick and easy, you know? They're all very quick and easy. You don't have to spend a million years doing it. You just a couple flicks and on to the next piece. If you were doing like 20 pieces at a time, you couple flicks for each piece. Production line, you know? Now we come to the fun part, or should I say more fun? Water bubbles. Take your water bubbles color. I love this color. Water bubbles. It's a beautiful sort of bubbly blue. I'm going to pour some of that on this side of my palette here. And here's where it gets a little bit tricky. And I'm going to take my smallest brush, the little details brush. Number one, Picorni brushes. And I'm gonna look at my piece, and now if you want, this is the way I painted them. You see there's little sort of barnacle holes? Just go and paint them in. You know? Just go and paint them in. That's it. You know, up to you how many of these barnacles you want to paint. I mean, just paint a few or paint a lot, you know, it's up to you. That's basically it. Now, after you do that, You want to paint some bubbles on the shore. I mean, you don't have to, but that's the way I painted my pieces. And if you prefer to, you know, not to do that, you don't have to, but this is going to take a little freehand painting. So, let's see. I'm going to just paint a little blue. See that? And I'm just going to decide where I want these bubbles. See that? Ooh, but I have a nice little bubbly thing here. Okay. And I'm going to do another one here. Okay. There we go. There we go. Okay. That's it. You know? It's up to you how much you want to do. Now, let's say you want to go a little crazy. And you're going, yeah, I'm going to put another bigger bubble here. Look at that. Could decide to do that if you want. Ta-da! Pretty much it. You could, if you want to, go back to your darker, shallow seaweed green there, and outline them. If you want to, outline them. You know? You could even decide to get a little bit fancy, you know? Get a little fancy, say, hey, you know what? I'm gonna throw some green in here. You know? Make them a little extra weird, you know? Just blend them in a little with some green. You know, you can have fun with this. You could just say, hey, want to throw in a little extra colors there. You know? Let's say, heck, what the heck? Let's say we wanted to throw in some school bus. Look at this. You can even do this. So you want to do that. That looks kind of cool. Let's say I want to go and bring up a couple of yellow things on in the barnacles here. You know? Look at that. You can add a little more extra variety under the waves. You know? If you really want to go crazy. You know? And you know? Who knows? What do we got here? You could get a little artistic, you know, say, hey man, let me do some mixing of some colors here, and be like, hey, let me get some green and some dark new here, you know, let's bring back a little green on here, you know. Who knows? It's up to you. You know, when you buy unpainted pieces, you can have fun. You can do anything you want. You could say, you could get a little weird and be like, hey, you know, what if there was some weird like tendrils coming out into the... What if there was like weird tendrils? Look at that. Some sort of weird tendril-like shapes coming out here. Look at that. What if you did that? Take my finger and just like rub this down. Look at that. Look at that. That look cool. So, it's up to you, you know, have fun. Okay, and now, once all the paint is dry, you go to the final stage. which is, let's make the water glossy. Let's gloss it up so it looks liquidy, so it looks like water. Now you can get your girlfriend's nail polish, you know, go down a store, buy any kind of nail polish, a generic cheap nail polish, you know, something that dries hard, you know. And we don't actually sell nail polish, so you're on your own. Pick up some kind of hard nail polish.
Clear.
I mean, you could experiment with, if they have nail polishes of different colors, you know, who knows? Maybe experiment with that. So here we go. We've got our painted piece. Now we're gonna take this nail polish we have here, and we're gonna paint it up. Just glob it up there, all over the piece. Oh yeah, and get it into the barnacles too. All the way up to the edge of the drawer. Now you want to do this in a room with a lot of ventilation, folks. When you're varnishing up like 50 pieces like this, it's going to get smelly. So make sure you get in all the nooks and crannies and gloss up your piece. Get the edges too. All right. Make sure you get those edges. All right. All right. And there you got your water tile piece, unpainted, and now painted.